Well, my friends, today I'm going to review this this beautiful, let me pass this thing on the side, this beautiful, well, beautiful, Tandberg TR2080, and yeah, and they are connected on my Heiko statements, the white speakers, yes. Later I will do a test with the Tandberg studio monitor speakers, the big speakers over here, and but now on the white speakers. And to be honest, I bought this receiver together with those studio monitors, and on the picture this thing looked very nice, but when I came there I saw, well, you know, look at this thing, what's this over here? What's this? You see? There's movement. And one of the bulbs are out. Also the, you see, this is the FM. The FM tuning bulb, yes, is out. Well, this one is working, the FM tuning bulb, but this bulb is out. I think it's the power meter, not sure. But the bulb is out, doesn't work. Yeah, it doesn't work. And I almost didn't bought this stuff, but yeah, I thought, okay, when will I find or score a set like this again? I mean, this is the top of the line receiver, the biggest receiver Tandberg ever built. And to be honest, people think this thing is beautiful. Well, I don't think it's beautiful at all. No, never thought it was beautiful. It's not my taste. I like more Marantz, Luxman, Akai, even Yamaha. I like more. I like more that style. I never liked the style of Tandberg. I earlier reviewed a pre and main amplifier, the 3020, more modern stuff, 2150 watt. That was a clinical sound. And you know, these things are always expensive. If you're gonna watch at Hi-Fi Shark, just on eBay, to see the price of a Tandberg TR2080, then you would think, why these things cost so expensive? They have only a weight from 12.5 kilo. 12.5 kilo, that's very light for a vintage device. They are from 1977, and people, believe me, you have to have this thing in your house connected to your speakers before you understand. Yes, is it a good sound? Yes, it's a very good sound. I will let you hear a few notes later how good this thing sounds. But can it compare, for example, to a, well, to my Soundsuite G901DB or G9000? No. The Soundsuite G901DB or 9000 still beats this thing, but it have a sound I never heard before. This Tandberg have a very pleasant sound. I tested it on several speakers, you know, to all my speakers, my Cantos, the Tandbergs, the Echos, and the small ones you see over there. I tested it first to see if the speaker connections, well, the thing was not broken. And I have to tell you that this thing sounds good on every speaker. On every speaker, this thing sounds perfect. But, well, perfect. You have to like the sound, but the combination with the Tandberg is very nice. And I'm gonna show you how this thing, well, this is how it is looking. Let me do first that have a three speaker connection, A, B, and C. I will show you also the back side of the thing, don't worry. Everything on its time. This is how it is looking. And some people think it's a beautiful receiver. Well, you know, taste. It's a matter of taste. I don't think it's beautiful. I prefer my Luxman R1500 or my Kai A1175 or most Marantz devices. I like more for the looks. You see, this thing is, you know, it's the building quality is not very I don't like the building quality, that's first. But it misses one knob over here, you can see speaker connection. And this is how it is looking, my friends, very simple. Very, very simple, but everything is working. What is this? This is sensitivity, input impedance. Not sure what it is. Min max. One sensitivity 150, 600 millivolt. Input impedance 25 kOhms. Well, not sure what it is. Maybe you can comment in the comment section what it is. It can handle the speakers from 4 to 16 ohm. Okay, this is it. It has two phono connections. And I'm not sure. Sensitivity 3 millivolt. Sensitivity 2.2, 10 millivolt. Okay. Min, max, you can regulate this one also. So probably for phone users. For phone users, this thing is an excellent thing, but I don't see a MM or a MC switch. Well, maybe it has. Let me see. You know what it is? If the thing is on the table, my view is like this. And I have to bend completely over to see what is written here. So I don't like the layout, that's first. I don't like the layout. It's not a good layout, you know, because if you're just sitting on top of it, you miss some, well, you cannot read what is written here. And anyway, this is the style from Tandberg. You know, I have a smaller Tandberg, I think the 2010 or the 1010, very small one, that thing have to be recapped. And I bought this thing as a set, so I, when I came there, I thought, well, you know, I had to pay much money for this set, and I thought, well, is it worth buying it, because it is not looking like I expected it was, you know. If you see the building quality, if you don't hear the sound, if you don't have knowledge about sound, and you only check out the building quality, you might think that, well, skip the thing, don't buy it, you know. They are better looking, better built receivers around there for that price, because these things are not cheap, my friends. Believe me, they are not cheap. And they are not cheap, and that's not because, well, I don't like the looks. Some people like the looks, I don't like these looks. But they are expensive because of the sound. And that's what I understand now. And I didn't never understand why these things were so expensive. But now I understand the sound is very good, you know. And I think you cannot find a TR2080 under 500 euro. No, I think this is impossible, almost impossible. And you have to be lucky to find one for 400. Anyway. And this is how it sounds, and I will make another video together with those matching Tandberg speakers. But this is how it sounds on my phone. And okay. Everything is in the middle, mid-range, treble, balance, volume, as you can see, volume, balance, bass, mid-range and treble, speakers, speaker connection B, that means the white speaker is playing, and we go on. So you heard this amplifier over my Heiko speakers, the white speakers over there. Yes. Scratchy, niet cleaning. Anyway, this was the sound over my Heiko speakers. I will do another test when I test the Tandberg speakers. And the review for the Tandberg speakers I will do with this same amplifier. I think it's a good match. I think it's a very good match. And, well, you know, these prices people ask for a Tandberg, I think they need recapping all of them. And the sound is good. But also a Marantz sounds good, also well, the prices they ask for these things, I would prefer myself to times 75 watt. If I would have the choice, I would choose for a Marantz 2265B. They cost also 600 euro at the moment, so same price, but the Marantz have a better building quality. They are stronger, and I think, for me, personally, they are better looking. But that's personal. There are many people around who prefer the looks of the Tandberg. And that's personal, my friends. I mean, I would go for a Marantz or a Yamaha or a Akai, you know, for the looks. For the looks, just for the looks. And for the sound, well, I think it sounds good, but it doesn't sound like my Samsung G9000. Yes, that was my best sounding device, but it sounds very nice. You know, and I now understand why these things are so expensive. not because of the building quality, but of the sound. Okay, thanks for watching. Put those thumbs up and don't forget to subscribe on my channel. Ciao, ciao.